I have my axis of rotation. It's negative x, z. It's a good idea to normalize this, but this'll do for now. If I look at my cube, it's pretty easy to figure out the diagonal directions themselves. Here's the easiest one. It goes from negative 1, negative 1, negative 1, to 1, 1, 1. So the cylinder's axis is 2, 2, 2. We can also use this vector's length to find the distance from one corner to another. These are the facts we need to continue. We've got the axis of rotation. We need the angle to rotate, and the length of the cylinder itself. Here's 3JS code that computes the cylinder's length. 3JS uses a class called Vector3. What you put in a Vector3, a point or a vector's coordinates, is up to you. Perhaps a better name might have been Coordinate3, but that's pretty bulky. Most graphic systems you'll encounter will call coordinates vectors, but it's easy enough to understand from the context what is meant. To find the cylinder's axis direction and length, I set up the two corner locations. I then subtract one vector from the other using the subvectors method, giving a vector from one point to another. There are a huge number of vector and matrix operations supported in 3JS. Subtraction is just one of many. Once we have the cylinder axis, this last line of code computes the length of this axis, which we'll need for knowing how long to make the cylinder. At this point, we have the axis of rotation, the length of the cylinder, but we don't have the angle of rotation yet. However, we have everything we need to get it. Given this cylinder's axis, we can dot product it with the y-axis, which is where the cylinder starts at, and then by the dot product of that and its final position, we will get the angle that we need to rotate. Remember that the dot product computes the cosine of the angle between two normalized vectors. So we normalize the cylinder's axis here and take its dot product with the y-axis vector here. This gives us the cosine of the angle, so we take the arc cosine to get the angle back, in radians. Using a dot product is a bit of overkill, by the way. Computing a dot product with a y-axis like this is the same as just grabbing the y-component of the sill axis. We could have simply normalized and done this, like this code here. However, unless this is a critical loop, like we're making a billion of these ornaments, I'd recommend using this first way. If someone reads or modifies this code in the future, the intent is clearer and more general. Now we have all the facts we need to make this object, the axis and angle of rotation, and the length of the cylinder. So let's get cracking. Well, I guess I should mention that the sine of the theta might be a little bit questionable here. We could use the right-hand rule to make sure we have the direction of rotation right. Or we could use the principle of negate and try again. I learned about this practice long ago from an article in an old trade journal called SGI Insider. It was great to realize that someone else was doing what I also do. If I put a rotation in and it goes the wrong direction, just try the opposite. So feel free to do the same, as you're in good company. You could spend 15 minutes trying to figure out the sign needed after some set of matrix operations and still have about a 50% chance of getting it right. Faster and more reliable is just to try it and see. That said, this practice won't help much if there are too many things to negate, or if the rotation is part of a long chain of transforms, or if you're starting from an incorrect algorithm. But if you're feeling the math is solid, go ahead and just do it. Using this principle with my test program, I found I needed to negate the angle to move the rod to the correct place. I guess I could have thought it through and realized that this was the right-hand rule and all that kind of stuff, but nonetheless, just trying it made me realize I needed to have a negative theta. I don't really like negative angles. I like to think positively. So I negated both the angle and the axis direction. This should give exactly the same rotation. If you rotate clockwise around one axis, rotating counterclockwise around the opposite axis direction is the same thing.